We are back just like I promised. We are now going to target the back. We got some bent over rows, some curls, and some snatches. All right? So we're going to have a little bit of fun today. We're going to switch it up with the reps, but I'll get into that in a second. Before we do anything, let's go ahead and warm up. So let's go ahead and get into some arm circles going towards the back. Open up nice and wide. Open up that chest. And switch it back to the front. There we go. And then you're going to come into some arm swings. Very good. Now let's go ahead, lock those hands out. Push the palms out away. And then you're going to hinge at the hips. Feel that stretch in your back. Feel a little bit in your shoulders. Try to reach for your heels so you can feel that stretch behind the knees. And then we're going to take it to the opposite direction. So you're going to get those hands behind your back, palms facing you. And you're going to lift those arms up as high as you can. You're going to feel that stretch along your bicep. And you're going to squeeze those shoulder blades, opening up that chest, getting those shoulders back. Let's keep it there. Hey, we are ready to get into this thing. All right, so like I said, I mentioned that we were going to be going into a different rep count. We got ladders today. All right, so this is how it's going to go. For the first segment, we got bent over rows coupled with high pulls. So we're going to be in a 3-to-1 ladder. So basically, when you're going into this bent over row, you're going to hinge at the hips. You're going to have that snatch grip, overhand grip over the biceps. You're going to push down here, and then you're rowing 3 times. Then we're going to come up, and we're going to get into some high pulls, hitting 3 on each side. And once we're done with 3 on each side, then we're taking it right back down to those bent over rows, and we're knocking out 2. And then 2 on the high pulls, and then we're going back down to 1, and then we'll work ourselves back up to 3. All right? So, remember, you want to hinge at the hips, get those shoulders back on those bent over rows for the high pull. I want you all remembering to get your elbows up and out and bringing your wrist to your chin and back down. All right, keeping the tension on your shoulders. Here we go. We're going with those bent over rows in 3, 2, 1. Push those hips back. Let's go. 2, 3. Good. Come back up. Two. Give me one more on each side. Take it right back down. We're knocking out 2 here. Back up. It's cool, because you're kind of getting 3 movements and 1. You're also hitting a deadlift as you go down into that row position. Then we're just knocking out 1 here. 1 on each side. Then we're coming back down, knocking out 2. There we go. Good. And then knocking out 3. Yes, we went down the ladder, and now we're climbing back up. Come on, get those elbows up. Excellent. All right. Go ahead, set those weights down. Shake those arms out. Then we're going to come back with some hammer curls and reverse flies. Staying with the same format. So with those hammer curls, going to get that neutral grip. Come up into that hammer curl. Knocking out 3. And then you're pushing those hips back. And you're going into that reverse fly. All right. So we are going. In 3, 2, 1, bring it up. Remember this, you want to stay nice and tall on these curls. Never want to hunch your back forward. Keep those elbows tight. Never going into those reverse flies. Good. Coming back up. Excellent. Push those hips back. Get that flat back. You want to focus on your rear shoulder. Good. One, one. Push those hips back. Good. Going back with two. Notice how my elbows are not coming forward on those curls, which is good because it keeps the tension on my biceps as opposed to getting work on my front shoulder. All right? You want to keep those elbows as tight as you can. There we go. Put those hips back. Last round of. There we go. Excellent. Set that weight down. Shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. And we're going to get into some shoulder work. So we're going to take a break from the ladder. And we're going to go into some 90-degree lateral raises. All right? Also focusing on the shoulder, but now you're focusing on the entire shoulder as opposed to a particular head. All right? And if you didn't know, yes, your shoulder does have three heads. Okay? So, you want to get 90-degree angle at the elbow, and you're coming up and out, all right? Those elbows out. We're going with 10 in 3, 2, 1. Let's lift up. Excellent. Y'all can stop me now. Listen, ready to shake it out. That movement there is perfect for people who have shoulder issues, shoulder pain, especially if you've been, if it's been recommended to you to not do anything overhead, but you still want to work your shoulders. That's an excellent alternative. Now we're going to get into some snatches. One of my personal favorites. Let's go ahead. Make sure that you're not getting anything too light. Because this movement here, this snatch, is a very forceful movement. All right? So before we get into it, I want you to think about the high pull. With the high pull, you're getting that elbow up and you're bringing your wrist to the chin. But then with the snatch, it's going to be just like the high pull, but now you're going to rip that weight up. So you're going to start off in a slight squat position. Weight starts getting to your heels, and then you're going to use your legs to power that weight overhead. All right? So if I have that weight, I'm here. And notice how I'm keeping that weight close to my body as I rip it up. All right? I'm not all the way out here with it. That's how you're going to tear your shoulder up. All right? So let's go ahead and get into it. We got 10 going in 3, 2, 1. There we go. Good. Open your mouth, give you a taste. Holla. Ain't no stopping me. Copy written. Nice. Don't copy me. Y'all do it sloppily. And y'all can't come. Come on, four more. I know you feel me now. I know you hear me now. I scream it loud and proud. Missy gon' blow it down. People gon' play me now. In and out of town. Nine, last one. With the crazy style. All right. Going in the opposite direction. Opposite arm. There we go. Come on. All right. Come on. 6, 7, 8, 9. Last one. 10. Great. Alright. Go ahead and take a sip of water. Alright. Let's start back from the top. Those bent over rows. Grab your weight. Push those hips back. Let's get into them. Make sure that you're squeezing your shoulder blades with those rows. Come back up. There we go. Come on, you got this. There it is, nice. For one. Excellent. All right, and we're gonna go into those hammer curls next. Go ahead and give your arms a break real quick. Come right back into it. Go on with those hammer curls. Good. Good. Hinge at the hips. Get that weight in front of you. Slight bend in the elbows. Nice. Coming back up. Knocking out our two. Go right back down into it. Coming up for the one. And then pushing it back. Excellent. All right. Take those arms out, and we're going right back to those 90-degree lateral raises. All right. Three, four, five, six, seven. 8, 9, last one, 10. Excellent. All right, time to get into that last set of snatches. Hopefully you guys have started to master these. So we got a second go at it. So again, weight starts in between your legs. Get those hips back, and then use your legs to get that weight up, all right? Remember, it's quick, it's a snatch. Here we go, 3, 2, 1, take it down. Come on, rip that weight up, rip it up. Good. Five. Six. Seven. Come on. Last one. Good. All right. We're going to switch it up. Let's go. Five, six, seven, come on, 8, 9, last one right here, stay with me, good, go ahead and set that weight down. That was our back segment, hope you guys felt it, got some good pull movements in there, see you guys for that next one.